instead of a senior speech, this is closer to a long dedication, or just a series of jokes. 5 years ago, as an eighth grader, this speech was my worst nightmare, because I thought I would have nothing to talk about. But in fact, if the school allows me, I can tell you stories for 5 days straight. I picked three of them to share with you. Number one, be alone is totally cool, but it's indeed quite wonderful to have friends. People know Iris Wei and I are kind of friends. I shared a short poem I wrote for her during English class. The title is Remember. Hey, remember the time we became friends? No matter if welcomed or not, you would come to my room after every history class in ninth grade. I guess it was because I had chips in my room. Remember your first birthday gift from me? Haha, it was an apple from the dining hall. Sorry, it was a common tradition. If you are smart enough, you will see it is indeed just an excuse for me to not buy anything. Remember the tennis matches we played together? We were so supportive as partners. I complimented every good ball you hit. You never blamed any mistake I made. We laughed at everything, even when a fire was burning in coach's eyes. You know, maybe that's why we were so bad. Remember the restaurant next to H Mart? You like spicy and salty food, but I prefer sweet and mild. Every time we would spend half an hour to order. By the way, you really need to take in less salt. Remember the weird time you fell into the strange habit of calling yourself my mom? It lasted a long time. Actually, it is still going on. Actually, it is strange. Stop it. Remember the friends trouble I mentioned to you earlier? I learned about serial killer in forensics class, and he primarily kills tourists. Yeah, I think I'm going home for spring break. Remember the snow candy we made on snow days? We stole honey from the dining hall and poured them on clean snow. Then we ate a honey snowballs. Our hands were red from touching the snow. Our teeth shuddered from the coldness. Our lips curled up from the sweet taste. Our eyes shone because we were friends. Arigato for giving me these memories. I am so lucky to meet you, my best friend. Number two, five-year roommates. We made the old field history. How rare is it to have someone who knows you as much as your mom? To me, Hira cannot be categorized into any title. She is much more than a mere roommate. She is a very nice person, and let me show you by the following little story, which she possibly forgot. In our eighth grade year, for our introduction to physical science class, we went to the Baltimore Aquarium. On our way back, in the school baby bus, Hira sat beside Nancy Lang, who fell asleep. The radio played a hit song at that time, Wrecking Ball by Miley Cyrus. The moment the song came on, everyone in that baby bus started singing along at the top of their voices. Like this, Hira curled up her hands to cover Nancy's ears, but not touching them because she did not want to wake her up. However, my five-year roommate Hira John could not resist the urge to sing along Miley. So the picture is Hira stretching her arms to cover Nancy's ears and reaching her neck as far away as possible. Screaming, I came in like a wrecking ball. I never hit so hard in love. While I cringed and laughed at that scene, the kindness I saw was radiant. It had the magic to warm up this unfair, judgmental world, at least little by little. It is almost impossible to tolerate me, someone who has screamed that I never want to grow up, someone who is so childish and selfish, for 5 years. You made me a better person. Thanks. Number three, when facing obstacles, just remember the worst conflict creates the best climax. If you're a friend of mine, you might have heard this story several times already, but so far, this still holds the gold medal in my story collection. My mother would always say I cry over everything. However, the moment I finish crying, that's the moment I leave it behind me. There are a lot of things that made me cry. My dreadful summer school memory at Cornell, tennis coach making me play number two single, and applying to colleges. But the most memorable one happened during my junior year's winter break. I was trapped in Baltimore by a net made of snow. My flight from BWI to Shanghai was at 6 a.m. on a Saturday of winter break. But it snowed. At 7 o'clock Friday night, as I carried my laundry bag back to my room, I received a message from Miss Libby saying, Wendy, the driver will drive you and Money to BWI at 9 o'clock tonight because the road is going to freeze. She then called Money, who is still at Hunt Valley. I took the fastest shower in my life and poured the fresh laundry into my suitcase, headed to the crosswalk. Thus the adventure began. Money, Miss Carol, the school bus driver, and I, heading toward BWI on an empty yellow bus that has the capacity of 25 people. Money and I sat for 10 hours in BWI, discussing if any of us would run for all-school president. I remember I answered no because I didn't want to write a speech. Clearly, young people change all the time. At 6 a.m., we parted when she boarded her plane to Canada, and I stepped onto the one heading to Los Angeles, where I would transfer to Shanghai. On a plane, the passengers waited for the airport crew to clean off the ice on the plane tires. The orange plastic needles on my watch ran after each other for rounds after rounds. At first, I was a bit worried because I only had 5 hours to transfer in Los Angeles. The delay might make me run to catch the next flight. After the fourth round, the fat needle rang. I knew there was no worry because I, for sure, would not be able to catch the next flight. And at the same time, a high-pitched voice came from above my head. The flight attendant said, "We sincerely apologize that the co-pilot's pilot certificate is expired." And why? He would be illegally piloting. We asked all the passengers to exit the aircraft. I was still calmed down. I came off the plane and joined the line for rebooking. After half an hour, I felt Shanghai. The conversation went like below. Receptionist, there is one flight from BWI to Frankfurt, then Shanghai, but the connecting time in Frankfurt is 20 hours. Me, is there any other option? Receptionist, there is one from BWI to San Francisco, then Shanghai, but only business seats are available. For international flights, United cannot compensate for free. You will need to pay for the extra. Me, okay, how much is that? $7,000. I said, I need to make a phone call. The calm I maintained for so long fell apart the second I heard my father's voice. It was 1 a.m. in China. My tears rushed out of my eyes like a collapsing water dam. However, at the last second, the receptionist found me a flight from Dallas Airport to Beijing the next morning. But the story is far from ending. I called a taxi to return to Oakfields to spend the night. As I silently cried in the taxi, I thought at least I could fold the clothing in my suitcase. But unfortunately, I did not meet a nice taxi driver. As we drove onto the highway, his car scratched another car. The other driver rolled down his window and yelled, "Hey." Before he could say anything else, my driver yelled out, "Criminals, you are all criminals." My driver was a white male and the other driver was a young black man. The cursing and shouting did not stop until two cars drove onto two different directions. At the last second, as the cars drove apart, the other driver threw something at a taxi, hitting a door next to me. I was never more scared and tired in my life. I had not slept in 30 hours. And worried if my taxi driver would hurt me. Luckily, I arrived at school safely. Miss Goldstein waited for me at the front door of Carol, and my sobbing was uncontrollable. I cried in my loudest voice in my room and fell asleep. The funny thing is, that was actually Mr. Tanner Reed's birthday. Because the roads to the outside world were all frozen, his birthday dinner of 2016 was spent eating orange chicken and fried rice in Oakfields with Miss Goldstein and an ice full of me. But my adventure has not ended. In the early morning, instead of me calling another cab, Mr. Tenery and Miss Goldstein drove me to Dallas Airport. However, when I was about to fall asleep in a car, they pulled a car to the side of the highway, telling me a piece of the truck in front of us had fallen off and got stuck under our car. Miss Goldstein told me not to worry. To be honest, I was not. I felt sorry and kind of funny seeing Mr. Tenery's sweatshirt and sweatpants soaked with snow on the ground. Trying to pull that ridiculous metal piece out from the bottom of the car. However, the initial attempt to park the car and wait for Miss Libby's rescue actually saved the car. Driving up a curb to the parking lot made a huge metal piece fall out. Finally, I arrived at Dallas Airport and flew home, 3 days after winter break began. P.S. If you can't see, I'm actually trying to say thank you. P.P.S. Iris's way back home that winter break was also pretty tragic. As if it was destiny, we found each other in Beijing Airport as our planes arrived in China, transferring to Shanghai and Xiamen. The hug we had when we saw each other was as if two long-lost sisters finally saw each other after 50 years. Life can be a difficult path with countless obstacles and choices, but the world has also put innumerable types of kindness around you. Both the obvious encouragement and the invisible warmth helped me to continue my adventure with a big smile, plus hope and excitement for every tomorrow. Despite my selfishness and immaturity, I try my best to be one of the kindest in someone else's world, and I hope you do too. My name is Yushan Wendy Wu, and I'm a 5-year senior.